Team, I love me, me, me. Welcome back. So, what is she doing here? Today is Saturday. It is December 2nd. What is she doing here? Did I miss a post? No, you didn't. I'll explain. Stay tuned. All right, team, I love me, me, me. So, in the spirit of Christmas, I decided to take on this Vlogmas challenge, which is basically vlogging up until Christmas, but I'm going to take it a little bit further and go to the last day of the year. So I'm going to vlog every day until December 31st. And so what I did is I put out a poll. If you are not following me on social media, then you need to start following me so you can participate in some of these polls. And basically what I did is put out a question to ask each and every one of you guys, what are some of the questions that you have that you just want me to answer? So for these next 31 days, I will be answering one question every single day with the exception of yesterday. I'm sure you noticed that I answered 5 questions. So that is the only day I will be answering multiple questions. Today until December 31st, I will be answering one question per day. So let's just go ahead and jump in. So somebody sent in the question, the infamous question, where can they meet successful single men? And I have 6 tips for you. So let's go ahead and jump in as usual. All right, number one. So the first best place to meet successful single men is actually online. Online dating is just so much more popular than it was back in the day. You are going to find creeps, but you're going to find creeps everywhere, right? You have to go out and actually meet these people in person so you're not spending multiple unnecessary time online, literally online, emailing back and forth. And then when you guys finally meet in person, number one, you don't have anything to talk about. Number two, you don't like the way they actually look. Number three, they might have catfished you. So don't spend multiple hours going back and forth. I know, ladies, this could be a security issue for you, but you have to really just step out and step out on faith. And just think about it. You could be out at the bar and meet somebody crazy, right? If they are a rapist, they're not going to tell you that they're a rapist, right? If they are a murderer, they're not going to tell you that they're a murderer, whether in person or online. So you have to do your research. Be safe. Meet them out in a public place for your first couple times. Do not, yes, I'm wagging the finger, do not go to their house for the first time that you're meeting them. You are setting yourself up for a disaster. So online for successful single men, because they don't have, they are not into the bar scenes, right? They're really not into the bar scenes. And I will do another talk about the bar scenes. So we're not going to do that here. But they're really not in the bar scenes. Number two, they might be busy doing other things. Number three, they're probably in activities that they really love to do. Whether it's skiing, snowboarding, it doesn't matter what the activity is. You're probably not going to find them in the bars. So you have to go online, places that you can meet them. They probably only check their accounts every few days or every week or so. So you have to still be willing to put yourself out there and go online. Spruce up your profile. I'm going to speak about all of this in future videos. So just online. Know that it's online. You can meet your guy online. I actually met my fiance online. I know that a lot of people are doing this now. I've met a lot of couples that met online. So you can find a successful relationship by meeting somebody online. All right, I'm gonna move forward. All right, so number two, you gotta step out of the box. In your hobbies, you can meet successful single men by doing what you love to do. I always say you gotta do you. And by doing you, while you're out there, out and about, you're having fun, you're living your life, you're doing the hobbies that you like to do, whether it's going to the library to read books, you can meet successful single men there. Whether you really like to swim, you can meet somebody on one of your swim teams. You like to hike, you meet somebody on one of your hiking teams. You really just have to do what you love to do. Put yourself in settings where you love to do things, so that way when you guys start to talk or when you see that guy, you already have some things in common. You can go be flirty and cutie, and you don't have to worry about, especially like let's say, for instance, let's use the example hiking, right? So in your hiking gear, you're not all spruced up with all your makeup and everything. Your hair might be pulled back into a ponytail where you just relax. You got on some of your workout clothes, you got on hiking stuff. It's not the sexiest gear, is my point. But he will see you in an environment where, you know, you like to do this. You can see him in his element, and maybe you can even ask for help, you know, damsel in distress kind of thing. So just, you can meet somebody by out there doing you. Do your hobbies, have a better chance of increasing meeting a successful single man, because he's out there doing his life. The third thing is that charity events. Don't forget about charity events. If you are a person that is into giving back, you can find somebody that actually meets up with that very thing. He likes to give back, you like to give back, you can start doing things together. This is one of the bonding things that you can start to do together. Obviously, you got to go out there and meet him first, right? So get out there to those charity events, especially if that's something that you love to do. You love to give back, you can find a guy that loves to give back as well. Number four is golfing. If you have not tried golfing, just go out there and try to get some golfing lessons. Don't be afraid to do these things by yourself, because when you are by yourself, men have a better chance of wanting to help you because they like to show you their bravado. They like to show you their strength, right? So put yourself in the situation where he can help you. Go and sign up for lessons if you don't know anything about golf, and start your golfing lessons. If this is something that's been on your bucket list, what are you waiting for? You can go to an indoor training, right? But get out there on the golf course to meet successful single men. They love to help. They love to show you off, right? They love to show you up. They love to show you what they got. They can get up behind you and show you how to stand and get you. Okay, you can't see me, but yeah, I'm turning to the side. I got my golf stance on. Anywho, moving on. The fifth thing is at high-end bars and pubs. So if you're looking for a successful single man who wants to get rid of all of the riffraff, he's just there to just chill, maybe have a drink or two, laugh and joke with his friends, or just kind of enjoy the environment, you have to go where he's going. So I hate to put it like this, but those cheapy bars where everybody piles into every first or every 15th or every Friday, that's not where he's at most of the time. Again, I'm going to come back to that, right? But go to the high end if you are looking for successful single men. Go to the high end sports bars, go to the high end pubs to meet your successful single man. The last and final place that I'm going to recommend, ladies, is actually at an auction. Are you into fine art? If you are, then go to an auction. Obviously, you're all spruced up and you're cute and everything, but you still, if you find somebody that you had your eye on, you watching them, whatever, etc., right? Put yourself in a situation where you have to go and ask him a question. You want to ask for help, right? And then you guys can hit it off. Now, disclaimer. If he is a really successful man, you have to watch who's there, because there could be an older crowd of people there. And why I'm saying this is because that successful single guy could be actually sending the older, more mature person there to do the auction for them. But you still got to check the ring, you still got to ask questions, you still got to do what you would do in a normal situation. But if fine art is your thing, or car auctions or anything like that, go to the auction. So these are the six places that I am recommending for you to meet your successful single men. Let me know in the comment section below. Have you been to any of these places? Did you meet your boo there? Because some of you guys are married that's watching my channel. So let me know where you met your boo. Did you meet him online? Where did you meet your boo? I would love to know, and some of the audience would love to know. And definitely check out the comment section to read what everybody else is saying, because you never know, you might find another place that I did not mention here. All right, now, finally, if you like this, give me thumbs up. I love to get thumbs up. And of course, subscribe if this is your very first time here, because here at I Love Me Me Me, I'm supplying you guys with the tips and tools in order to have happy, healthy, romantic relationships, so we could decrease that divorce rate by simultaneously increasing the marriage rate. I love you guys, and there's nothing that you can do about it. Mwah!